each other. So I have actually been working on all the chakra systems in the past, oh gosh, must be 6 weeks now, with everyone at City Yoga and We Yogis at Equinox. So with that being said, I'm going to continue that on, just happens to be live now. So go ahead and lie on your back as we begin your heart chakra work. As you lie in Shavasana, just begin to breathe normally. As you lie in Shavasana and breathe, take your ankles, your heels, mat width apart. As you take them mat width apart, let the hips have that natural external rotation. Bring the hands by your side and just be. Take two or three breaths here. And when you're ready, just begin to bring your hands to your heart space. Just bring the palms on top of one another. And if you're just now joining us, feel free to meet us in Shavasana. Noticing your breath is a major part of your practice, that pranayama. Hands come to your heart. Listening to what your heart has to say. Maybe that becomes your intention as you allow the body to float. You feel that gentle gravitational pull, but realistically, it's like the union of opposites. That gravitational pull draws you into the earth as you lift up from the mat when you breathe in. When you think of your heart chakra, it's signified by air and social identity, which I find completely apropos considering these times that our social interaction just looks different. And it might affect the way that you identify socially. Take a deep breath in through your nose, sigh it out through your mouth. Do that twice more. Inhale through your nose. Sigh it out through your mouth. This last time, breathe in that intention, that heart-focused intention that you've chosen. And release everything holding it back. Your next breath brings you to a long body stretch. Reach your arms all the way over your head, legs over towards the edge of the room. And as you exhale, draw the right knee into your chest. Just finding some lateral movement of that right knee coming inside and outside. Maybe rolling out your ankle. Keeping your shoulders on the mat. Take your left hand outside your right knee. Draw it over to the side for a gentle spinal twist. Taking the opposite hand towards the opposite wall. Gazing towards your right hand. Just easy twisting here. Letting the breath do the work. Inhaling back through center. Draw the knee back into your chest. Open up that hip. So as you have that open hip, maybe some movement is allowed. Maybe you keep stillness. Inhale back through center. Grab the back of your hamstring. Extend your leg up towards the ceiling. Take an inhale as you lengthen. Point the toe. And exhale, set it down onto the mat. Inhaling the left knee in towards your chest. Drawing it in, maybe some movement. Deep breath in, right hand comes outside the left knee, draping it over, opening the left arm towards that side of the room, gazing, softening the breath, letting that twist occur naturally. Inhaling back through center, gently draw the knee into your chest. Grab the back of your hamstring, extend the heel towards the ceiling, feeling that hamstring lengthen, point the toe, inhale, exhale, draw it back to the mat. Long body stretch, reach, 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 reach. Exhale, draw both knees into your chest and just find some lateral movement side to side, massaging the base of your spine. And as we come up to a seated position, it's just gonna be one fluid movement. Grab the backs of your knees, inhale, exhale, sitting up, right where the soles of your feet meet the floor. Your hands come right in front of your knees, or you can keep them behind. It's completely up to you. We find cat and cow from this position. So you inhale, open the heart, breathe through the back of your ribs. Exhale, arching your spine, opening the heart from the backside. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale. Once more, inhale, and exhale. Coming back to a gentle neutral spine. Cross the legs for Sukhasana, that's a cross-legged position. You can see me facing this way. As you catch this position, bring both hands back to your heart. Shake your head no and shake it yes, just releasing any tension there, and close down your eyes. Coming back to that gentle intention that you've set for yourself. Coming back to that recognition that the social identity from your heart just looks different. And we get to accept it for where it is today. Take some deep three-part breaths. So you breathe into your belly, up into your ribs, up into your chest. You inhale, think four counts in. And exhale, four counts. Find that two more times. Deep belly breathing, opening up through the ribs, opening up through the chest, and letting that breath out. Releasing the tension, but staying long and lean up through the body. Do that twice more, rather once more, as this is our third round. Inhale, and exhale. Gently open your eyes, and just twist to your left. Take your right hand outside the left knee, and take your left hand behind you to keep your chest elevated, twisting open, keeping your hips stable and soft. Every inhale you expand, every exhale you twist deeper. Last one, and breathe out. Coming gently back through center. This time take a long reach up for the ceiling. Exhale, twisting over to your right. Left hand comes outside your right knee, twisting as you exhale. Inhale to expand. Exhale to twist deeper. Good. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Gently coming back through center. Reach the arms high. As you exhale, press forward onto your hands and your knees. So you catch yourself in a box pose. Now I want to open this up to some organic movement for yourself. I want you to learn your body, but keep the knees underneath your hips. Palms are underneath your shoulders. Lock the elbows out. Draw the eyeball of your elbow forward. As you inhale, you lower the belly. And as you exhale, you arch the spine. Now, take a few rounds of this on your own. Maybe you flip your wrists. Take advantage of this moment to start learning your body, but all the while that sternum is reaching forward. And then you're concaving, your chin comes to your chest, that pelvic movement is also tucking underneath you. Take three more rounds here. Noticing your breath, noticing where your mind is going. Is it coming back to your mat? Or are you focusing on the intention here? Let yourself truly be here. We're gonna have some fun today, don't you worry. And I want to make sure that you stay as present as you possibly can. Coming gently back to a neutral spine. Make sure that all fingers are facing forward. Your fingers are spread wide. Neutral spine, so your belly is pulled in, but you're not extending here, and you're not curling under. The spine is long from the crown of your head all the way to your sacrum. You're going to take your right arm, reach it forward, extend your left leg. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, draw your knee into your elbows. You push the floor away. Inhale, re-extend. Exhale, draw it in. Inhale, re-extend. Exhale, draw it in. Last time, inhale, re-extend. Place the hand back on the mat. Drop the foot down and walk yourself to the left-hand side of your mat. Now, it feels strange, so pivot onto your right knee so that leg is facing towards the back. Now as you step and lift up onto your knee, reach your arms high, big inhale, gaze towards your hands, exhale, side plank, support it. Reach the left arm over, lift the leg high, long body, you're pressing through your shin and the hand. Take three deep breaths. Looking underneath your left armpit. Does it smell good today? And as you find your next exhale, grab the back foot with your left hand. So your left foot, left hand. Push your foot into your palm to open, expand the heart. All the while, the right hand is super grounded. Deep breath. Without flicking, extend back. Dropping the left hand back to the mat. Left toes touch. Re-pivot on that right foot. Shake that right leg out. Come back to your gentle box pose. If you need some spinal movement here, go ahead for it. Otherwise, take a deep breath. Let it out. Left arm extends, right arm reaches, left arm rather, right leg. Inhale, expand. Exhale, draw it in. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Last time, extend. Left arm reaches out. Drop the right toes, drop the left hand, walk it over to your right, pivot onto your left, compromising position, I know. Reach, sit up onto your left knee, reach the arms high, deep breath in, exhale, plant the left hand, reach the right arm forward, that easy side plank here. Hold for three breaths. Breathe in and out. In and out. Good. In and out. You're here at an easy side plank. Begin to grab the back foot with that right hand. If it's not available to you, that's okay. Just maybe bend the knee. Push the ankle into your palm and lift the heart. Breath in. And without flicking, you re-extend. Bring the right hand down. Repeat on the left foot. Come back to your box pose. Take a few cat and cows here. Really let the spine be articulate here. Shaking left, shaking right. As we take a few moments, we're gonna get into your core. It'll be very simple. You're gonna stay in your box pose. I want you to push the floor away, tuck the toes underneath you. As you push, you lift your knees about 3 inches off the mat. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift again. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, exhale, lift. Round 3, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale as you lower. Exhale, 4. We're going for 5 rounds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower down. Last inhale. Exhale, fire up the belly, gently tuck the pelvis for 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower all the way down. Walk your hands a little bit further out. Shift your weight forward, extend the legs back. Catch yourself in a plank. Squeeze the inner thighs together, push the other way. Deep breath in. Exhale, downward facing dog. It's your first one. Pedal it out. Press the floor away. Shake your neck, yes. Shake a no. Deep breaths here. Maybe shift the hips. But firmly plant both hands down. Gently walk your hands all the way to your feet. Catch a gentle ragdoll. As you grab opposite elbows, I really like to take your hands, place them inside that crease of your elbows. And just gently sift side to side. Maybe find some buoyancy in your knees. Notice that connection of your quad to your belly. Release the hands to your mat. Heel toe your toes together, heels slightly apart. Roll up one vertebra at a time. Inhale your arms straight to the sky. Bring your palms together. Bring it down to your heart space, samasthiti, and just be for a moment. Be at one with your breath.
taking a few moments to come back to that heart space and that energy that you've created, that intention that you've chosen. And breathe, keeping your eyes closed down. As we go introspective, for that social identity and how different it may look and feel, we are still energetically connected from our heart space. Take a few more breaths. Letting any tension be released. It's our gentle responsibility to not be concerned or worried, to sit in silence, to sit in peace. Gently opening your eyes, reach your arms all the way up towards the ceiling as you exhale, forward fold. Inhale to lift and lengthen. Exhale, plant the hands down and walk yourself back to your plank. Notice your hips are not shifting. Keep them stable. Maybe take the feet a little bit wider. Breath in here to lengthen. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now the difference that I want you to feel is I don't want you to be just a straight plank to a down dog. We find ourselves our next plank. Push, articulate the spine all the way back to your down dog. And then reverse it all the way back to your plank. Exhale. Inhale. Do that twice more. Exhale. Inhale. Last one. Gently drop down to your knees, catch yourself in a child's pose. Reaching the arms forward. Taking the elbows down to your mat, bring your hands to prayer behind your spine. Opening up your armpit, then heart space opens towards the floor. Coming back to your pranayama, the breath, maybe it's a three-part breath. Maybe it's your ujjayi breath. Last one. Gently plant your hands back to your mat. Reach forward and then plant them underneath you. Downward facing dog. Lift the hips all the way up. Situate yourself here, finding strength. Lay that heart space open down towards your thighs. Inhale the right leg high. Shift your weight forward. Drive the knee into your chest. Step it between your palms. Drop the back knee. Untuck the back toes. Salamba Anjaneya. Low supported lunge. Be here for a moment as you expand the heart space. One more breath. As you're dropping the shoulders away from your ears, you plant the left hand down, runner's twist. Open the right arm all the way for the ceiling. As you twist open, press through the left hand as strong as you can. Fire up the left glutes. Wild thing. Step your right foot behind your knee. If you need to drop it for a moment and stabilize your left hand, you can. Press the hips high. Open the right arm, reaching from behind you. Gaze towards your right fingertips. Now here's the float. Keep your arm reaching forward. Float it all the way to a high lunge. Anjaneya Asana. Staying high on the ball of your left foot. Drop the knees, tucking this right underneath you so you're feeling the fire building in the front of your body. As you scissor your right arm back, drop the right knee, left knee down. Open the right arm, untuck the back toe as you twist. I know it's challenging. You're twisting over the right thigh. Drop the right hand. Inhale, reverse gaze towards your left palm. Exhale, prasal, reach a wide-legged forward fold. And just be. Maybe you shift your hips side to side. Your toes are in, heels are out. Maybe you pull up your socks. Totally your call. I'm gonna give you the opportunity, if you wanna join me, take your hands underneath your shoulders. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, fold deeper. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold deeper. Last time, inhale. Exhale, fold deeper. Stay for three. Stay for two. Stay for one. Gently walk yourself to that low lunge top of your mat. Open the right arm, runner's twist. Reach the right arm as high as you can. Exhale, cactusing your arm. That right arm drops towards your lap. Inhale, back to your center. Drop the right hand. Step the foot back. Find yourself in your plank. Pull the belly in. Drop the knees. Drop your chest and your chin. Snake it through to your low cobra. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, come down. Twice more. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, lower. Knees come wide. Toes to touch. Press back to your child's pose. Breathing into all the strength as we're taking the sternum and opening it up. Take a few breaths here. Open the heart. Find that patience and that airy feeling. Reminding yourself that you have the right to be loved and to love from here. Breathe in, let it out. Inhale, let it out. Once more, inhale and let it out. Good. Make your way back to your downward facing dog. Plant the hands down. Lift the hips. Think the hips are lifting up towards the ceiling rather than pressing the heels down. But a strong downward facing dog. Get all the wiggles out if you need to. As you find stillness in a strong dog, pull the belly in. Lift the left leg all the way up. Exhale. Draw the knee forward into your chest. Step it through. Salamba Anjaneya. Low supported lunge. Think of the heart space opening here. Breathing. Dropping the shoulders. Opening up that right psoas. As you exhale, fire up the back leg. Plant the right. Open to a runner's twist. Left arm reaches high. High on the ball of the right foot. Pushing the earth away. Now is the time to ground through your right foot and your right hand. Wild thing. As you step it behind, remember you can come down. Otherwise you're lifting. Opening up that heart space. Pushing to the right foot. Reaching the left arm for the front of your room. Floating to an Anjaneyasana high lunge. Ah! Top of your mat. Ooh, deepening this opening space. As you scissor your left arm back, you drop the back knee, untuck the back toes. Feel that twist. Stay here for two. Stay here for one. Drop the left hand, reverse. Look towards your right hand. As you exhale, prasarita, wide-legged forward fold. Super compromising position. You're welcome for some of you. Shift the hips side to side. Take the hand underneath your shoulders. Inhale, lift if you want. Just so you can see. You can inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. One final time. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. And hold for three. Hold for two. Hold for one. Gently walk it back to a low lunge, top of your mat. As you find your low lunge, take the right hand, plant it down, open the left, find your runner's twist, and then cactus your arm open. Inhale back, Place the left hand down, step your left foot back. Strong plank, squeeze your inner thighs together, pushing the shoulder blades up to the ceiling, belly in. Drop your knees, chest and your chin. Snake it through to your low cobra. Inhale higher, exhale down. Twice more. Inhale and exhale. Squeeze your inner thighs. Inhale and exhale. Knees wide, toes to touch. Press back to a child's pose. This time, take your hands back behind you in prayer. As you open your heart towards the center of the earth, remind yourself there's energy that you're contracting, that you're receiving. Breathe into that energy right here, in that heart space. Deep breath and release. Inhale, exhale. Inhale that you have the right to be loved, and exhale. Making your way back to a downward facing dog. Let's be a strong dog. Here we go. Downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in. Side out through your mouth. Do that twice more. Inhale. Side out. Inhale. Side out. Good. Inhale the right leg high. Step it through. Anjane Asana. High lunge. Strong. Straighten the back leg. Fire up your left glute. Pull the belly in. Exhale, standing splits. Ground through your right foot. Lift the left, flex the toes down towards the floor. You're folding over that right thigh. Release the neck. Find some buoyancy there as you strengthen that right leg. Now, finding warrior three. Lift the heart space. Leg stays as it is. Dekasana your arms. Open the heart. Squeeze the shoulder blades back and down together. Deep breath. Exhale, strong foundation into the earth's core. Inhale, warrior one. Floating back. Drive the right knee forward. Square off the hips so that back foot's at a 45 degree angle. Your first time here. Fire up that back leg. Take your hands behind you so you bind them. Drop it down. Inhale, lift the heart space to reverse. Exhale, humble warrior. Drive yourself inside that right leg. Breathe here. Leading the grateful heart. You have a body that can move. Keep your bound hands. Prasarita, wide-legged forward fold. Toes in, heels out. Release the neck, but you're driving the hands closer to the opposite side of the room. One more breath. Release the hands gently back to the earth. Straightening the legs, take your left palm in the center of your chest, pressing away. Inhale the right arm high. Gentle twist here. And slowly taking that right hand down, inhaling and exhaling the opposite hand high, keeping your sacrum as flat as you can. Gently coming right back down. Now underneath your shoulders, inhale to lengthen. Exhale, grab the backs of your ankles. Folding deeper, use your biceps to draw the heart space between your legs. Release your neck. Two more breaths. One more breath. And gently release. Walk into a low lunge top of your mat. As you find yourself here, lift up underneath your pelvic region to come to an Anjane Asana high lunge. You've been here before. Now open up to your warrior two. The first time you've been here. The strong warrior. Bend that right knee, right in line with your toes.
Fire up the back leg. That femur bone drives up into your hips. My shorts keep getting shorter. Sorry, not sorry. Opening up from the heart. So think your arms reach from the heart space. Inhale to reverse. Straighten that front leg. Exhale, triangle pose. That right arm reaches as far forward, keeping your hips stacked. Drop the hand inside your right thigh. Left arm reaches high. Try not to press onto your knee here. You can be on your shin, inside your calf, but you're opening the heart space. If you want to find a half bind here, take your left hand inside your right hip crease. Breathe. If you're bound, re-extend that hand. Use your obliques. Come all the way back to a reverse triangle. Exhale, side angle pose. Reach the right arm forward. Bend the right knee. Come inside that right thigh. Push your tricep into your adductor there. So you're finding that activity, that connection. Breath in. Come back to your warrior two. Inhale to reverse, cartwheel this down to your low lunge. Step your right foot back to meet your left. Find yourself in a plank, and we find our articulation again. Push the other way, downward facing dog. Lift the hips. As we come back forward, pull the belly in, arch your back, and then come to a high cobra. Letting the hips not sink, it's very active. You're pushing away, heart space forward. Articulate the spine right back to your downward facing dog. Inhale back to your high cobra. And one more. Find as much articulation as you can. Pressing the other way to your high cobra. Coming back to your downward facing dog once more. As you find your strong dog, drop your knees. Child's pose. If you want to find your female child's pose with your thighs together, totally fine. Take a few breaths here. Come back to your mat. Come back to your gentle intention. And breathe. You have the right to be loved. As you breathe in, you're imagining you're floating on that cloud of energy that you've now cultivated from the earth, because you know that we are all one. Breathe. So you find your second side. Be patient with your body. Be patient with your mind. Staying for a breath. We're meeting you back in your downward facing dog. Here we go. Down dog. We all meet there. Drive the hips up towards the sky like you're floating into the clouds. Press the other way. As you become one, that heart opens. You lift the left leg high. You shift your weight forward, drive the knee into your chest, step it through, Anjane Asana, high lunge. Breathe. Opening the heart, cactus your arms back, drop the elbows towards your lats, open up the heart, inhale, back through center, standing splits, ground through your left foot, lift your right, flex the toes back towards your face. Relax the neck.
Sorry, I'm not sure.
Alexa, I did not say hi to you.
Gently sorry, releasing. I don't know that, but I do have a skill you might like.
I don't know what
it's
kind of...
It's called repeat after me. Want to try it?
I do not want to try that, Alexa. Pull the belly in. Warrior three.
I don't know that.
Lift the heart.
I don't know that. But I do not.
Just enjoy this laughter for a second. Opening, expanding the chest. Breathing in, finding yourself to a warrior one, facing the front of the room. Now keep your hips square. Open up the chest. Bend that left knee deeper. Take the hands behind you.
Inhale as you bind them, lift the heart. Exhale, humble warrior.
Sir, I don't know that, but I do have a skill you might like. It's called repeat after me. Want to try it?
No. Fine here, humble warrior. Back to my compromising position. Come back to your prasarita, wide-legged forward fold with your hands bound. Take a moment to find stillness as you pull the hands away from your spine. Take a breath in and gently release that back to your mat. Place the hand, your left hand, underneath your heart space. Inhale the right arm high, keeping your sacrum flat, secure. Taking that right hand, replacing it. Inhaling your left hand. And then coming back down to your mat. As I rejoin you in this wide-legged forward fold, come back to the front of your mat. You're in this low lunge, so you can lift from underneath that pelvic region. Pull the belly in. Lift the heart. Anjaneyasana, high lunge. Deep breath in. Open up to your warrior two. Strong position as you open those hips. Come deep into that left knee. Reach the arms away from you, from the heart space. Gaze towards your right fingertips, make sure they're one long line. Inhale, reverse, straighten your front leg. Exhale, triangle pose, Trikonasana. Extending your left arm as high as you possibly can. And then, as far forward, then drop it. Right hand comes high, gazing towards your right palm, or maybe you half bind inside your left hip crease. If you're bound, unbind. Use your obliques. Inhale to reverse. Exhale, side angle pose. Reach the left arm now, taking it in. Right arm reaches high. Press the tricep into your left adductor. Again, opening the heart towards the ceiling. Inhale, back to your warrior two. Inhale to reverse. Exhale, cartwheeling all the way down. Plant the hands, step your left foot back to meet your right. Articulating through our plank and downward facing dog. We push the earth away, lifting the hips, working through the spine, dropping the heels, and coming right back forward. Chin to your chest, pulling the belly in to a high cobra. Press firmly through your palms. Inhale, articulate. And come back forward, back to your high cobra. Final time. Coming back forward. We'll meet back in a downward facing dog. Squeeze your glutes, inner thighs. And drop to your knees. Shift your weight to your heels, child's pose. Take a moment. Come back to the breath. You're doing great. Come back to the intention. The gentle understanding and opportunity that you, I just saw, Alexa, mind your business. Alexa, do warrior three. Alexa, breathe. Here we go. Breathing
in. Sorry, I don't know that one.
Into your heart space. As you come back, just sit onto your heels. Push back onto your heels, cross your ankles. Send your legs in front of you. As you send them in front of you, bring your thighs together. Articulate through your spine all the way down. And while you're here, squeeze your inner thighs together. Press your lower spine into the mat for just a moment. Then drive the elbows down right next to your body. As we move into fish, keep your hands, chest hands, reaching towards the ceiling. Lift the chest, press into your elbows, so you're lifting, 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 and then the top, the crown of your head, just barely rests onto the floor as you're pushing your elbows further into the ground. Breathe, easy breaths.
Opening up that heart space. Gently come out of that one vertebrae at a time. Placing the palms on the mat. Heels come in towards your glutes. Find an easy bridge pose. As you gain this knowledge of your spine, maybe you take wheel. If you want to take it, bring the palms behind you, facing towards your feet, and press up. Use your whole posterior as you lift up. Otherwise, you're in this easy bridge pose. Maybe you bind your hands behind you, wiggle your shoulders underneath you, pushing the palms deeper. Three more easy breaths. Taking that full Dhanurasana if it's there for you. One more. And then slowly begin to come out of that one vertebra at a time. Belly draws in, extend your legs out. Take one long body stretch. Feel the energy expand. Then drive your right knee into your chest and cross it over for a spinal twist. As you take that spinal twist, you've been here before, so that right knee crosses. You keep the heart space opening up straight to the ceiling and you gaze towards your right hand. Remembering that airy feeling. Gently come back through center. Re-extend the right leg out. Draw the left knee into your chest. Find that gentle compression there. And then cross your left over your right. Gaze over to your left palm. And just breathe in this gentle twist. Try not to force anything. Gently coming back through center, drive the left knee back into your chest, re-extend, grab the backs of your knees, rock and roll three or four times, massaging the spine, meeting me facing forward, Paschimottanasana, taking yourself here in this forward fold. Pull the flesh away from your sits bones. If your thick thighs save a lot of lives, flex the toes back towards your face. Reach the arms high. Exhale, forward fold over. But I'd like you to grab the outside edge of your feet. So you're grabbing your pinky toe edge, pulling it back towards your face. Take an inhale to let the heart open. Exhale, use your biceps to fold forward deeper. As you're using your biceps, it's the upper body strength to pull the heart closer to your thighs and maybe a slight bend in your knees. Also totally okay. Breathe here for five. Breathe here for four, for two, and one. Slowly roll up one vertebra at a time and make your way all the way back onto your spine. Now listen closely, I'm gonna explain this to you versus showing you so I don't like annihilate my apartment or my chairs. But as you make your way to shoulder stand, think about it coming in from plow. So as you go to plow, take your legs all the way over your face, all over your head. Place your fingers, your palms, right here on your lower spine. See how my fingers are facing towards the floor? Drive your elbows behind you. So you're coming all the way on top of your shoulder blades. And then wiggle your elbows as close as possible together. Once they're there, lift one leg off at a time. So it's balancing posture. It's not a forceful posture. As you balance, you lift one leg and then the other. Easy breath because your throat is contracted here. If you're not interested in shoulder stand, take your legs up the wall. Totally fine. You're breathing here for five. You're breathing here for four. Three. Two. And make your way to plow pose. You were just there, but now keeping your legs straight. Descend them over behind you. So keeping your legs straight is going to access that posterior to open it up. As you take them down, maybe your toes touch, maybe they don't, but you're still supporting yourself with your palms, right? All that energy is still located right at the base of your spine. Then if you want deaf man's pose, you can drive the knees down towards the ears. Breathing gently and making your way slowly, one vertebrae at a time, all the way down to Shavasana. As you take your Shavasana, I want you to take it just like you did at the beginning of your practice. I want you to take both hands to your heart space. Bring the palms on top of each other, taking your heels mat width apart, and letting an external rotation do its work. As you make your way there, I'm gonna give you about 20 more seconds. I want you to find whatever makes you feel really good about your practice. If it's one more posture, if it's a more intense spinal twist, if it's a forward fold, I want you to make sure that this practice is yours as you begin to open the heart. And I'll give you some affirmations in a moment. But just take three more breaths as we all come to Shavasana together. Because there's nothing more than accessing your own social identity with other people that are practicing exactly the same moment as you. As you take this Shavasana time, I love this song. It's a live version of Sarah Bareilles, and I hope that you enjoy it. And it is 6 minutes, so please know that we are going to stay here together for 6 minutes in fellowship, in opening up that heart space and recognizing that we have the right to be loved. She gives you the gift of song. Remember the affirmation of I am worthy of love.
To be
in a few more breaths as you recognize that the energy is something that you've created this entire time. It stems from your heart space, that heart that you're leading with is a grateful one. Your next breath takes you to a long body stretch, reaching your arms all the way overhead, legs reaching towards the front of the room, your room. Your exhale draws your knees in towards your chest, and you fall into one side or the other. giving yourself that safe space as you hold. Holding the energy for humanity. You come up to a Sukhasana, a cross-legged position, the top of your mat, keeping your eyes closed down. You bring your hands to your heart space and you take in that love that first and foremost you give yourself. When you cultivate that generous love from within, it radiates to everyone else. And right now, more than ever, this is that opportunity we get, that responsibility we have to honor that energetic light full of love from within. As you inhale your thumbs to your third eye, that we're able to honor that divine light in others as we bow and say, Namaste.